In this tutorial, we will learn animation in CSS using keyframes from styled components. So CSS keyframes determines what styles an element will have at a given time. They are responsible for controlling intermediate stages of an animation. A keyframe allows greater control of an animation's progress. To utilize this property, we need to install styled components. Then at the top, right after the CSS file, let's import styled from styled components. And since keyframes comes from style components, let's import it as well. Right after styled, between brackets, let's use keyframes. The keyframe syntax consists of two things. Keyframes must have a name that binds the animation to the element. So right here, let's declare a constant for text fade is equal to keyframes and double backticks. Then this property has two values, from and to, which determines the value of the animation at the start and at the end. So let's start with from and then to. Everything that we put in between these brackets will be the initial state of the animation and the final state of the animation. So let's start with opacity at 0, and then let's use a transform. Translate y of minus 10 pixels. So our animation will start with 0 opacity and coming from the top. So the final state will be opacity at 1 and transform. Translate y at 0 pixel. The animation must be defined in the animation name property of an element. So here, let's declare a constant for the title is equal to styled.h1. So here, replace the h1 tags with title. Then, inside of the backticks, let's add animation name, then $ in brackets because it's a variable, and here we can add our text fade. And so we can see it better, let's add a duration. So animation duration to 1 second. So now refresh your page. And as you can see, the title is animated. You can also use percentages to have more control over the timeline of the animation. As a result, you will be able to control anything in between, like adding new properties at a specific point in the animation. So here, let's change from to 0% and to 100%. And in between, let's say at 80%, we can change the values. So this will make the animation less linear. So opacity at 0.5. And let's keep the transform at minus 10. So let's refresh. And now, as you can see, it is less linear. So now let's talk about animation properties. Here we have animation name, which specifies the name of the keyframe. Then we have the animation duration, defines the length of an animation. The third one is called animation delay. And this determines the delay of the start of an animation. So for example, let's put it at 2 seconds. And now refresh. The actual animation will start 2 seconds later. The fourth one is animation iteration count. This one sets how many times to play the animation. So let's set it at 3 and refresh your page. And you will see that it is playing 3 times. Then we have the animation direction. This one can go forward or reverse. And if you use the reverse, you will see that the animation is going from 100 to 0. So let's refresh. The next one is animation play state. This one indicates whether the animation is running or paused. It is commonly used when you do not want your animation to run when it's not in view. So if you put paused, you will see that the animation will not play. And if you put it back to running, it will work. And the last one is animation timing function. This one sets to how an animation progresses through the duration of each cycle. My favorite one is in out. Your code will become very bulky if you add animations to every element, as you can see. So let's combine all the values. Values can be arranged in any order except when both delay and duration are used. And you will see that by using this method, you will have fewer lines of code. So here, let's use the property animation. So the first one is the name. So we can just add our text fade. Then add a space for the duration, 1 second. Then animation delay to 0.1 second. Then we will skip the animation iteration count and move to forward with the ease in out. So now we can delete all of this. And it will do the same animation. So here you see that when you refresh your page, we actually see our element, and then the animation is running. To fix that, let's just set the initial opacity to 0 as well. Keyframes are also reusable, so you can add them to any element. Let's declare a new variable for caption is equal styled.h2. Then we can replace this tag with caption. And let's copy the CSS of the title, but inside the caption. And instead of using 0.1, let's change this value to 0.5. So as you can see, it is applying to both elements. And what's amazing is that you can have multiple animations for a specific element simply by adding a comma between animations. So here, let's add a new one for text slide is equal to keyframes. Then we can start at 0% with a transform, translate x of minus 20 pixels. Then we can use the same code, but instead at 100%, let's set the translate x to 0. So now, on the caption, at the end, just add a comma, then $, text slide, with a duration of 1 second, 0.5 delay, forwards, with the ease and out. And this is how you combine two animation at the same time. So let's run it. So this is the end of the tutorial. I hope that you liked it, and I'll see you on the next one.